Hi children, in this video we are going to learn 6th standard mathematics chapter whole numbers topic properties of addition. In this video we are going to learn properties of addition. There are closure property, commutative property, associative property, additive identity, and exercise problems. Now let's see properties of whole number. We already know children, we have four arithmetic operations. There are addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. The properties of whole numbers are based on the arithmetic operations, such as property of addition, property of subtraction, property of multiplication, and property of division. So here, properties of whole numbers is help us to understand the numbers better. Moreover, they make calculation certain operations like. Now we will learn properties of addition. They have four properties. First one, closure property, commutative property, associative property, and additive identity. First, let us see closure property. So let us understand with one example. Here, how many boys are there? Five boys. And how many girls are there? Two girls. So let's find the total number of children. So we have to add number of boys and number of girls. So we get 7. So here 5 and 2 are two whole numbers, then the result is also a whole number. So let's see the another example. 10 plus 13 equal to 23. Here 10 and 13 are whole numbers and the result 23 is also a whole number. Next, 200 plus 31. So the result is 231. Here 200 and 31 are whole numbers. The result also a whole number. So we learn from this, when we add two whole numbers, we always get the sum also a whole number. So we define the closure property as, if A and B are two whole numbers, then A plus B is also a whole number. Let's see the second property, commutative property. See children, here having two tables. So in each table have two bowls. In first table, first bowl have 3 oranges, second bowl have 5 apples. So in second table, first bowl have 5 apples and second bowl have 3 oranges. So let's find the number of fruits in each table. So let's find the first table. In first table, the total number of fruits are 3 plus 5, we get 8. In second table, the number of fruits are 5 plus 3, we get 8. See children, here both tables are having same number of fruits. So here The numbers will be interchanged, but its sum is same. So let us understand with some more examples. Here 10 plus 15 equal to 25, then 15 plus 10 equal to 25. So here numbers will be interchanged, but its sum is same. Let's see the another example. 100 plus 250 equal to 350. Next, 250 plus 100 equal to 350. Here also the numbers will be interchanged, but its sum is same. So we learn from this, the numbers will be interchanged, but its sum is same. So we define the commutative property as, if A and B are two whole numbers, then A plus B equal to B plus A. Now coming to the third property, associative property. So here Rani and Vani went to a market and bought ice cream, popcorn and burger. So here the cost of ice cream is rupees 30. Cost of popcorn is rupees 20. Cost of burger is rupees 50. So now how much money should they pay the shopkeeper? Yes, very good, rupees 100. But Rani and Vani and add two different ways. So Rani first add the cost of ice cream and popcorn and then add the cost of burger. So rupees 30 plus rupees 20, rupees 50 plus rupees 50, rupees 100. And Vani first add the cost of popcorn and burger and then add the cost of ice cream. So rupees 20 plus rupees 50, rupees 70 plus rupees 30 equal to rupees 100. See children, here both way of approaching gives the same answer. So now let us understand with another example. Here A equal to rupees 100, B equal to rupees 400, C equal to rupees 150. So first add 100 plus 400, then add rupees 150. So 100 plus 400 we get rupees 500 plus rupees 150 equal to rupees 160. Next, first add rupees 400 plus rupees 150 and then add rupees 100. So rupees 400 plus rupees 150 equal to rupees 550 plus rupees 100 equal to rupees 650. The another method, first add 150 plus rupees 100 and then add rupees 400. So we get rupees 250 plus rupees 400 equal to rupees 650. So we learn from this, when we add three or more whole numbers, the number can be grouped in any manner, the sum remains the same value. So we define the associative property as, if A, B are three whole numbers, then A plus B in bracket B plus C equal to in bracket A plus B plus C. Now coming to the fourth property, additive identity. So here, how many students are playing? Yes, 9 students. So let's assume that no students join in between until the end of the class. So now, how many students are there? 9 students. So we learn from this, when you add 0 to any number, it does not change the value. Let's see some more examples. 15 plus 0 equal to 15. 200 plus 0 equal to 200. 0 plus 325 equal to 325. 0 plus 563 equal to 563. So we learn from this, when you add any number to 0 or 0 to any number, it does not change the value. So we define, if A is any whole number, then A plus 0 equal to 0 plus A equal to A. Let's see additive identity. So let's see one example. Here 5 plus 0 equal to 5. 5 plus 1 equal to 6. 5 plus 2 equal to 7. Another one, 7 plus 0 equal to 7. 8 plus 1 equal to 9. 6 plus 0 equal to 6. See children, here 0 added to any number, we get the same value. That is, adding 0 to any number, it does not change the value. So for this reason, we call 0 is the additive identity. Now let's recall properties of addition. So first one, closure property. If A and B are two whole numbers, then A plus B is also a whole number. So the second property, commutative property. If A and B are two whole numbers, then A plus B equal to B plus A. Third property, associative property. If A, B, C are three whole numbers, then A plus in bracket B plus C equal to in bracket A plus B plus C. Fourth one, additive identity. If A is any whole number, then A plus 0 equal to 0 plus A equal to A. Now coming to exercise problems. Exercise 2.2. Second problem. Add the following numbers using convenient association. First one, 557, 692, 443. So we already know, when we add three or more whole numbers, the numbers can be grouped in any manner, the sum remains same. So while adding three or more numbers, we group them in such a way that the calculation becomes easier. So we arrange the suitable and add. So we will observe the digits at the unit place of the three numbers. That is one space of the three numbers. So here the sum of 7 and 3 is 10 with 0 at the one space. So therefore, first we will add 557 and 443 and then add 692. So 557 plus 443 equal to 1000 plus 692. So the final answer is 1692. Next, second problem, 1382, 1118, 2500. So first we will observe the digits at the ones place of the given numbers. Here the first number ones digit is 2. Second number ones digit is 8. The third number ones digit is 0. So let's find which two numbers or adder 0 comes in, it's the one space. So therefore, the sum of 2 and 8 is 10. So, with 0 at the one space. So therefore, we will add 1382 and 1118 first and then add 2500. So here 1382 plus 1118 is 2500 plus 2500 we get 5000. Third problem, add 1487 plus in bracket 1313 plus 2137. Also add in bracket 1487 plus 1313 plus 2137. Are the results same? Which property of addition is used while comparing? So first we will add 1487 plus the sum of 1313 and 2137. So we get 1487 plus 3450. Now let's add 1487 and 3450. So we get 4937. So second one. So now first we want to add 1487 and 13. So the answer is 2800 and then add 2137. So now 2800 plus 2137 we get 4937. So now the results is same. Next here we have to use associative property of addition. Fourth problem, Use convenient grouping to find the sum of the following. Second sum, 625, 730, 375 and 270. So first, we will observe the digit at the ones place of the given numbers. When any two numbers are added, 0 comes in its first place, that is ones place. So here, the sum of 5 and 5 is 10. So that is the ones place is 0. So first, we are group 625 and 375. Next group 730 and 270. So let's add 625 and 375. We get 1000. Next one. 730 plus 270 is 1000. So now 1000 plus 1000, we get 2000. Next, the third problem, 2491, 3108, 1508 and 1992. So observe the ones place of the given number. So the sum of 8 and 2 is 10. So we form the group. The first group is 2491 and 3108. The second group, 1508 and 1992. So now let's add 2491 and 3108 is 5599. And then add 1508 and 1992 is 3500. So let's add 5599 and 3500 is 9099. Thank you, children.